Center has issued a fresh set of guidelines for COVID management in children and advising against the use of antiviral drug remdesivir. The center has suggested the use of paracetamol and warm saline gargles to manage mild infections. Use of steroids has not been recommended in mild and moderate cases, whereas in severe cases, a 6-minute walk test for children above 12 years has been recommended. This needs to be done under the supervision of parents and guardians to assess the oxygen levels. And if there is a low oxygen level, then of course concerns are to be raised with the competent medical authorities. Now, this is the overall guideline that has come through from the Center on COVID management in children. With the onset of the monsoon season, the government of Maharashtra has recommended administering the flu vaccine to children. Speaking exclusively to Mirror Now, Suhas Prabhu, Maharashtra's head of COVID task force, said even though flu shot does not prevent COVID, it does help in reducing temperature and consequently the burden on health services amid the pandemic. It can also help filter out non-COVID related symptoms, since the symptoms of COVID and flu can be very similar.
The Maharashtra task force is also recommending that children should be given their flu shots, before obviously the onset of the monsoon. Is that something, if you can just explain why that recommendation is being given and whether or not it would in some way help, obviously since children are not able to get vaccinated at the moment, what is the thinking behind that?
Thank you, Avni, for asking that question, because this has been, if I may use the word, misreported in the press. I'm not really blaming the press. Maybe they didn't understand what the message was.
Okay.
We are not saying that influenza vaccine prevents COVID. Although there are one or two papers somewhere we say, I don't think that's standard accepted medical fact. Then what is the idea of saying that give influenza vaccine? Let me come to the point. I mentioned sometime earlier that when the child gets fever, you don't know whether it's COVID or whether it's influenza, whether it's malaria or whatever. So every time the child gets fever, there is a panic. The mother thinks my child has got COVID. So if we can prevent any fevers to any extent, it will allay the panic. That's point number one. Second is it will reduce the burden on the health services. Remember, every child with fever, the mother is going to take to the clinic. So that's an extra burden on the doctor. Now, as I said, the child may not have COVID, may have flu, may have something else. He goes to a fever clinic where there are other children who might be actually COVID. So this is might be a what you call super spreader site where the child does not have COVID, but because he got flu and was taken to the center, he catches the infection from another child who's got COVID. So this is the second point. The third point is the fact that, remember, flu itself can create problems, although it's not as dangerous a disease as COVID. And I don't know whether you are aware of the fact that the Indian Academy of Pediatrics has a vaccine advisory committee. And this committee has anyway said, even before COVID, that all children below 5 should receive the vaccine as a routine. Now, this has been followed more in the breach than in the practice. So we are taking this chance to reiterate the fact that it's a good idea to give a child flu vaccine every year. And we are recommending now, because in India, the flu season is the monsoon season.
Yes.
In the West, it's winter. So in several European countries, US countries, everybody gets the flu vaccine, not just children.
Yes.
It's given by the government and routinely in October or November every year. So why not do it here? After all, we are there for the health of children.